Hello friends, subscribe to our channel GDC and press the bell icon for more updates.
Hello friends, welcome back once again. In the today video class lecture, we are going to discuss various chemical tests of carbohydrate. So if you will get an unknown substance, then how you will determine that this is the carbohydrate? If this is the carbohydrate, then which type of carbohydrate, either polysaccharide, monosaccharide, disaccharide? So there are the different tests which applied to distinguish and identify the exact carbohydrate in that mixture. So if we took any mixture, on this mixture we applied the Mollis test. Mollis test. If any substance will give the Mollis test positive, then that determines that this is the carbohydrate. So if Mollis test gets positive, then this is the carbohydrate. Now we have identified that our mixture given the Mollis test means this is the carbohydrate. On this carbohydrate, now we will apply iodine test. Iodine test. If iodine test goes positive, means on the reaction with the iodine our carbohydrate gives the positive, then it can be starch or dextrin. The main identification, if our compound is starch, then that will gives the blue color, and if it is dextrin, then it will shows the purple color on the junction. And if the iodine test comes negative, then that will be the except starch and dextrin, that will be the glucose, fructose, either maltose, lactose, sucrose, means it can be glucose, fructose, lactose, maltose or sucrose. These are the possibilities. Now on these substance we applied the Benedict test. If we applied the Benedict test, Benedict test is used for the differentiation of the reducing sugar and non-reducing sugar. Then two scenario will become: reducing sugar will be differentiate and non-reducing sugar. Reducing sugar and non-reducing sugar. If Benedict test comes positive, then that will be the reducing sugar, and if Benedict test becomes negative, then that will be the non-reducing sugar. Non-reducing sugar, there is the example sucrose. Example of the non-reducing sugar is sucrose. For the confirmation of the sucrose, on this we applied the hydrolysis. Hydrolysis. On the hydrolysis, this sucrose will get break down and form glucose plus fructose. This is the non-reducing sugar. Now example of the reducing sugar. Reducing sugar can be glucose,
fructose, maltose and lactose. Here glucose and fructose, these are the monosaccharide, and maltose and lactose are the disaccharide. Now this is the only one we have applied the hydrolysis and found that this is the sucrose. Now in the reducing sugar, we will apply the different test to differentiate monosaccharide and disaccharide. Now in this reducing sugar, we will apply the Barfoid test. If this Barfoid test comes, there are two scenarios, either it can be positive or negative. If Barfoid test comes positive, then it will be the monosaccharide. Example, glucose and fructose. And if negative, then it will be the disaccharide, that is maltose and lactose. Now this monosaccharide, we have to differentiate glucose and fructose. The main difference between the glucose and fructose is that glucose is aldehyde in nature, while fructose is ketone group. So on this we will further apply Swellenhoff test. This Swellenhoff test, if there is the precipitate, if after the Swellenhoff test any precipitate will be formed, then it will be the fructose, and no precipitate, then it will source the glucose. This is the differentiation. Swellenhoff test is used for the identification of fructose and glucose, means mainly it used for the identification of the ketone group carbohydrate. Now this disaccharide will further identify that this is the maltose or lactose. So all these, glucose, fructose, maltose and lactose, these are identified on the basis of ozone test. Ozone test is mainly applied for the identified by their different crystal form in the ozone test. So which crystal form in which test, let's see. On this disaccharide, now we will apply the ozone test. Then in the ozone test, there are chances, if in the ozone test there is the sunflower shaped crystal or puff shaped crystal. Puff-shaped crystal determines the lactose. If puff-shaped crystal form, then means it's the lactose. And if sunflower-shaped crystal form, then it means that this is the maltose. Ozone test is also given by the glucose and fructose. If glucose and fructose applied for the ozone test, then this glucose and fructose gives the needle shaped crystal. So these are the different tests. Let's have a quick revision. Firstly, what happened? We took the mixture. On the mixture, we applied the Mollis test. If Mollis test comes positive, then it means this is the carbohydrate. On this carbohydrate, we applied firstly the iodine test. Iodine test differentiate starch and dextrin. Starch shows blue color, dextrin shows purple color. Well, if iodine test becomes negative, then it will be glucose, fructose, lactose, maltose or sucrose. On this mixture, we applied the Bendick test. Benedict test is used for the differentiation of reducing sugar and non-reducing sugar. If Benedict test comes negative, then it will be the non-reducing sugar, that is sucrose. On the hydrolysis, we can confirm if the glucose and fructose forms that this is the sucrose. Now, if it the reducing sugar, then there are two possibilities. It can be monosaccharide or disaccharide. In the monosaccharide, glucose or fructose. In the disaccharide, it maltose or lactose. On this reducing sugar, we applied the Berfoyd test. Berfoyd test, if comes positive, then it will be the monosaccharide, and if negative, then that will be the disaccharide. Now, in the monosaccharide, we applied the Svelinov test. Svelinov test is used for the differentiation of ketone and aldehyde carbohydrate. If Svelinov test gives the positive precipitate, then it will be the fructose. If negative, then it will be the glucose. On the Ossazone test, these both glucose and fructose form needle-shaped crystal. While on the disaccharide maltose and lactose, if we applied the Ossazone test, then it forms sunflower-shaped crystal, then it will be the maltose. And if puff-shaped crystal, then it will be the lactose. So these are the different tests which applied for the identification and differentiation of the various carbohydrate. Let's see the various chemical tests of the carbohydrate and their observation and what are their inference. So first, Mollis test. The reagent of the Mollis test are the alpha naphthol plus concentrated H2SO4. When Mollis test and reagent is alpha naphthol plus concentrated sulfuric acid, when this applied on the mixture, then what happens? Violet ring at the junction of two liquid. If this will form, then it shows the positive observation and it shows for the common test for all carbohydrate. Next chemical test, we have applied iodine test, polysaccharide, on this polysaccharides we add 1 to 2 drops of iodine, and what happens in this blue color precipitate, and if blue color precipitate will form, then it will be the test for the starch. It is the test for the starch. Next, third, Benedict test. In the Benedict test, we took copper sulfate plus sodium bicarbonate plus sodium citrate and boil for the 2 minutes. Now it will be the boil for 2 minutes. And on the boiling, this precipitate, if it shows green, yellow or red precipitate, then it shows this is the reducing sugar. There is also another test for the identification of the reducing sugar, and that test name is known as the Fehling test. In the Fehling test, what happens? We took the Fehling solution A and Fehling solution B. Fehling A plus Fehling B and we boil it for 2 minutes. On the boiling, it shows yellow or red precipitate. If yellow or red precipitate comes, then it's confirmed this is the reducing sugar. Okay, next test, Barfoid test. In the Barfoid test, we take Barfoid reagent. On this Barfoid reagent, we go for the water bath heating. And on the water bath heating, if it shows brick red precipitate at bottom of test tube, then it confirm Barfoid test is for the identification of the monosaccharide and disaccharide. Differentiate mono and disaccharide. Okay, next test, swelling off test. In the swelling off test, swelling off reagent, if we add the swelling off reagent, then red precipitate, and this will distinguish keto and aldo carbohydrate. Keto and aldo carbohydrate. And lastly, next, ozazone test. Reagent of the ozazone test is phenyl hydralazine hydrochloride. Plus sodium acetate. Add water and the water bath heating for the 20 minutes. On this, different shaped crystal forms, that gives the differentiation of the lactose, maltose, glucose and fructose. So these are the different chemical tests for the carbohydrate with their observation and inference. Thank you.